Let's head into this morning newscast with the latest coming in from China, as we are now being told that four people have been killed by the deadly coronavirus that took over the world. More than 218 cases have now been detected in China alone, and the number keeps rising. Meanwhile, a World Health Organization emergency panel will meet this week to discuss the SARS-like virus that has spread beyond China. China has now confirmed human-to-human transmission of the new coronavirus. A new case has also been reported in South Korea. South Korea's Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has confirmed that it is a 35-year-old Chinese woman and a resident of Wuhan. She was detected with symptoms of the virus while entering South Korea and has been isolated since. The patient felt symptoms such as fever, chills and muscle pain. South Korea has raised the infection alert level from attention to caution following the case.
확진 환자는 검역 단계에서 확인되어 지역사회에 노출은 없는 상황입니다. 항공기 동승 승객과 승무원 등 접촉자는 현재 조사가 진행 중이며
The outbreak took place in the Chinese city of Wuhan. A total of 218 cases have now been reported in China. Four people have lost their lives following the outbreak of SARS-like coronavirus in China. The disease has also spread to Beijing now. At least two people have been detected with coronavirus-related pneumonia in the capital. One case has also been reported in Japan. Two cases have been reported in Thailand. Third country to get affected is South Korea. Now let's also have a closer look and understand the virus. Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses that cause illness ranging from common cold to more severe diseases like Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. A novel coronavirus is a new strain that has not been previously seen in humans. Coronaviruses are zoonotic. It means they can be transmitted between animals and people. The outbreak in the Chinese city of Wuhan is being linked to a large seafood and animal market. It suggests a possible zoonotic origin to the outbreak. The World Health Organization has listed some of the common signs and symptoms of the infection, which include fever, cough, shortness of breath and breathing difficulties in severe cases. Pneumonia, severe acute respiratory syndrome and kidney failure is also reported. The Union Health Ministry has swung into action. The ministry has issued a travel advisory for China and also reviewed India's preparedness. Travelers from China will be screened at Delhi, Mumbai and Calcutta airports. Now, what to do if you feel sick on the flight back to India? Immediately contact the flight crew and ask for a face mask. Remember to avoid close contact with fellow passengers and follow the directions of flight crew while disembarking. Meanwhile, Chinese President Xi Jinping has said that the virus must be resolutely contained. China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs says that the country is dealing with the situation in the most serious and professional manner. Let's also have a look at the precautions more closely. The World Health Organization has advised people to avoid close contact with people suffering from acute respiratory infections. Avoid touching eyes, nose or mouth with bare hands. Avoid travel to farms, animal markets or slaughterhouses. Refrain from consuming raw, undercooked meat. Avoid any contact with sick animals or spoiled animal products. And so even as alarm bells are ringing over the mysterious killer virus in China, an Indian national has fallen victim to the SARS-like coronavirus. Preeti Maheshwari, a 45-year-old school teacher, has been admitted to a hospital in Shenzhen since the 11th of January. Maheshwari teaches art at the International School of Science and Technology and is the first foreign national to be infected by the deadly virus. She's suffering from type 1 respiratory failure, multiple organ dysfunction syndrome and septic shock. Maheshwari's brother has also launched an online campaign to raise funds for the Indian National's treatment, which is estimated to be at around 1 crore Indian rupees.